Hi and welcome to another video for linmob.net. This is my second unboxing already, and it's not of the Ubiports community edition, but of the postmarketOS community edition. And I just opened that cardboard box there, but I didn't open this one yet, so let's go ahead. Now, didn't find my scissors. Did not want to use a knife, so I'm using that old rusty thing. And this is a nice box. I like that there's some source code printed on the front. Boxy, and then we've got an introduction to postmarketOS, but it's really short, so not much in there. And this is the PinePhone user manual, and well, I have had a PinePhone since late June, so I won't read that, I think. And yeah, this here seems to be the PinePhone. Yeah, that's it. And that's the back. Pretty nice, powered by Linux, not GNU Linux. Before we continue with the PinePhone, let's have a look at the other things. This is one of their nice red cables. Not sure whether it was wrapped in extra plastic last time. And yeah, USB A to USB C, nothing special there. They packed an adapter for if you've got a nano SIM, so that you can use it as a micro SIM here. And then, because this is the postmarketOS Convergence Edition, a nice little dock, and that has USB-C port here and two USB ports, one HDMI port and LAN. I don't know whether that's gigabit LAN or not. And then here is another port for power, I think. Yeah, looks like it's for power only. Great. Now let's try to power up the phone, but first let me peel off this thing, because otherwise it's annoying. And now we need to open the phone. And if you're going to get a PinePhone later, please remember this, because it's in the manual too, but you really need to open it and then move the battery, remove this plastic thingy here, and then yeah, put in a SIM card or a micro SD card optionally, and put the backpack on. Feels a little bit different from my Ubiports community edition. Maybe they refined it a little here. And now let's see if this thing turns on now. Yeah, it turns on. Great. PostmarketOS. And now I expect to see that quick start, first run experience anytime, and then yeah, continue. Let's set a numeric pin. Okay, that Well, that was a little bit confusing. See, they match, okay. Then SSH. And I think they give a really good description here. I will enable it. Set username, which is going to be, and password, which is going to be, well, I'm gonna change this anyway, so it's going to be top secret for now. Full disk encryption. Yes, why not? Going to choose something stupid here too. Oh, it has to be 8 characters. And now it's ready to install. And this may take 20 seconds. Well, I think I've got that patience. Okay, maybe it's taking a little bit longer than 20 seconds. But that's a good opportunity to clean up a little bit here. Now it seems to be rebooting. And now I have to remember my little full disk encryption password here and type that in. Hopefully that was successful. Yes, it was. And there we are. That's Phosh. That's the welcome screen here explaining a few things like open, close the top menu, tap the top bar, connect to Wi-Fi. Okay, that's something we're gonna do right now because I want to apply the updates. Great, we're connected. And now let's start Gnome Software. Let's see if I can apply the updates that way. Close that menu here on the welcome screen. And yeah, there aren't many apps pre-installed. Calls, chats, contacts, calculator, clocks, Firefox, settings, and terminal and text editor. And this might actually be a Firefox ESR. Okay, so something failed apparently to download. Let's see which version of Firefox this is. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that this is the good old one. Help. Yeah, Firefox 68 right now. And now let's just see if we can hit update all here. And now it should download all those updates, which are many. I think pretty much every package is getting changed, and we're moving on to the current extended support release of Firefox here, for example. A later version of GNOME Desktop. So on, and now it seems to hang a bit. Nice. Or not nice. Well. That's, you know, it really hangs. But it always does on camera. It's really crazy. Well, it feels like a bigger deal on camera, because now I need to figure out, can I force a restart here, or shouldn't I, or should I just wait, because likely something's gone wrong here, and I don't know what, and yeah. I think I'll just wait a bit and speed up the video. I could turn the screen off here, but I can't turn it on easily. Because apparently the system is so bogged down now. But it's a major update, I mean. I think I will just force it off now and restart it. Okay. Now let's see. Whether something went wrong here. And I will try to update using the terminal, because that's usually the safer way to do it somehow. GNOME Software integration on many distros is still hit or miss. I know that because I've had a PinePhone for months now. So, this is the old keyboard. There's a new revision of it out by now, but it's not too bad. What I like about this one is, while the keys are a little small, it has these has a tab key, which is really helpful for tab completion. I really like that. Generally. Okay, now let's upgrade, and I think if I go to 80% here, screen looks a little bit more sane. So there's a new kernel going to 5.8. Non-free firmware, so on a new release. Non-free firmware parts for this device are, I think, mainly, that's mainly stuff like the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth module. Don't think the modem needs actively loaded firmware that has to be supplied on the file system. And also autofocus for the camera, maybe. And because I saw an U-boot update, I will try to... Oh god. Yeah, the keyboard is broken. But now it's fine again. I hope that's the command. I don't really remember. Yeah, it is. Great, now we can just reboot the phone and see what's different. Well, if it comes up again, who knows that? But that should happen. Hopefully. It's looking better. We should be booted up soon. Yay. Now we still don't have a camera up here, but that should be easily installed and you can just run sudo apk add megapixels and password, whatever your login pin is. Oh, I mistyped there apparently. Now let's see if it's there. Here we go, and let's try to start that one. And it's working. It's less smooth than it was on my other PinePhone, so maybe this is an older release. Because on my other PinePhone I have got the experimental repository for made by the developer enabled, which is even faster. And now let's briefly see my camera setup here and me. Hello. Yeah, so the camera works generally on PostmarketOS these days with Megapixels, which seems to be the best app out there. And that is all for this unboxing and upgrading and installing a camera app session of the PostmarketOS Community Edition PinePhone. Here. So, thanks for watching and see you soon. Bye.